Good afternoon, student. Now this is the lecture second for the rock and soil properties. So now in the last lecture you clearly observe the properties of transverse strength. Now shear strength. Shear strength is nothing but the resistance offered by the stone to shear stresses, which tends to move the one part of specimen with respect to the other. It is obtained by using the relationship with shear strength of the stone, which is also not commonly determined except when the stone is to be used as a column. So S is equal to P upon 2A, P is a load of failure, A is equal to area of cross section of the specimen. So it is has been observed that shear strength is the most common building stones, ranges from 70 to 140 kg per centimeter square. In the laboratory testing, a bar shaped specimen is held the grip end and is supported and ends below is loaded from the above. Rupture occurs when the shear strength is exceeded. Strength, tensile strength. Tensile strength of rock is related to its ability to withstand breakage, and it happens after some level because that level is its strength. It is determined directly, indirectly, and it is the tensile pulling strength that it has to be applied to a material to break, and it is measured to force per unit area, and is a direct method would be required. Elaborate means avoid bending while applied the tensile forces by gripping the specimen. At the end, since tensile stresses as a seldom required accurately indirectly method is commonly applied, in the direct method is Brazilian test. You very well known about the Brazilian test. It is consist of loading test, cylindrical diametrically in such a way that apply loads as would be developed tensile rupturing long the diametrical plane of the specimen. Load are generally increased till the cylinder fractures. The load P at the rupture being thus known, transverse strength T is calculated by using the formula TS is equal to 2 pi upon nu DL. D is the diameter of the specimen, L is the length of the specimen. So here is the equation. Now the porosity. The porosity, the shape and size of the nature of packing of the grains of the rock give the rise of the porosity, property of the porosity or the development of the pore spaces within the rock. Numerically, it is the expressed the ratio between the total volume of the pore spaces and total volume of the volume of the rock sample. Porosity is commonly given in percentage term. Presence of interlocking crystals, angular grains of the various size and abundant cementing materials are responsible to low porosity stones. Conversely, the rock will be highly porous. It is composed of spherical and rounded grains, that is the example of sandstone, or if cementing material is distributed unevenly is poor character. Porosity is important engineering property of rock. It accounts for the fluid absorption value of the stones is the most cases, and also that higher porosity signifies a lesser density, which generally means lesser compressive strength. Porosity values for few common building stones: granite 0.1 to 0.5%, basalt 0.1 to 1%, sandstone 5 to 25%, limestone to 5 to 20%, marble, it is a metamorphic rocks which is having 0.5 to 2%, Quartzite is also metamorphic growth 0.1 to 0.5%. Then absorption value, it defines the capacity of stone absorb the moisture when immersed in water for 72 hours or till gates full saturation. It generally expressed in percentage terms. For original dry weight of the mass, it may be obtained for the relations absorption value is equal to Ws minus W0s upon W0s into 100. That is the Ws, it is the weight of saturation. W0 is weight, dry weight of the sample used. Then permeability. Permeability, it is the capacity of the rock to transmit the water. Sandstones and limestones may show high values for the absorption or 10% or even more. Selection for such highly porous variety of the stones for use the building construction, especially in the most situation, would be greatly objectionable. Presence of water within the pores not only decrease the strength of rock but also make the stones is very vulnerable to the frost action in the cold and humid climate conditions. Now the property of density, it is defined as the weight as per weight per unit volume of substances, but in the case of rock it is not only the solid mineral matter which is wholly accounts for the total volume of the given specimen. A part of the rock may be comprises for pores or open spaces which may be empty or partly filled or wholly filled with water. According to three types of density may be distinguished in the rocks. First is dry density, second is bulk density, and third is saturated density. The first is dry density. It is the weight per unit volume of absolutely dried rock specimen. It includes the volume of pore spaces present in the rock. Second, bulk density, weight per unit volume of the rock sample and the natural moisture content where the pores are only partially filled the water. Saturated density, it is the density of saturated rocks or weight per unit volume of rock in which all pores completely fill the water. The fourth type is also recognized, true density. It is a weight per unit volume of the mineral matter without pores or water of the rocks is made up of. The most engineering calculation, it is that bulk density which is used frequently. Bulk values in gram per cubic centimeter for some common building stones, granite 2.7, basalt 2.9, sandstone 2.6. and limestone 2.2 to 2.6. Abrasive resistance, it is a more qualitative than quantitative property. This may be broadly defined are the resistance which a stone offer to rubbing action of one kind or another. Determination of its considerable significance when stone are intended for use a situation where the rubbing by natural or artificial causes it involved as routine. Example, stone used a paving along roads. Second, facing stones is building of where arid regions where the strong sand laden winds are blown. These types of situation demand stones that have not only have abrasive resistant but also essentially uniform composition, so that the wear is uniform is as possible. Stones composed of more than one mineral like granite may look quite appealing in such cases when fresh used, but within short time they may be pitted and disturbed because the unequal wear of the different mineral components. Frost and fire resistance. May building stones show quick disintegration of building stones for rock when used situation involving frost formation. Excessive cold or heating. Frost cause disintegration by expansion of water on breathing within the rock pores. In the case of fire, the unequal expansion of in different mineral components and also different depths from the subsurface inwards may cause disintegration. This effect becomes more pronounced when the rock first heated and suddenly cooled by water. Heavy stones including granites crumble to cinder. Such treatments, it is too easy understand that rock which are found porous and weak in strength. They show very poor frost resistance. Thank you.